The New Forest Fruit Company are growers of the UK's earliest, sweetest soft fruits in one of the most beautiful parts of the United Kingdom. Nestled between the Solent and the New Forest National Park, Newhouse Farm, the home of the New Forest Fruit Company, enjoys a unique microclimate, allowing the production of the best strawberries in the country. The story of the strawberry starts in the glasshouse and in the polytunnels, where the soft fruits are cultivated and picked from purpose-built rows on substrate soil. The New Forest Fruit Company enjoys a very long harvesting season, as owner and managing director Sandy Booth explains.
We have a really unique microclimate down here. We are literally 2 miles from the Isle of Wight. The Isle of Wight for us is like a windbreak. It breaks up any winds coming straight off the coast. And that's why I think we can grow good quality strawberries from March to November, because of the climate that we have in this area. The bulk of what we do is strawberries. That's my passion. That's what I love doing. I love taking something that is a flower and turning it into a fruit 35 days later. And I think that's the magic of strawberries, really. There's nothing else like it. It's hard work, it's long hours, but it's the reward in turning something from nothing to something. That is the real key in strawberry production. And of course, for me, the one big thing is that when people pick up a punnet of strawberries, just come back for another one. Not once a week, hopefully 3 times a week, hopefully every week.
In order to get the strawberries into the shops, they have to be grown. And for that, soil is needed. But not the soil you might expect. The New Forest Fruit Company uses cocoa peat, which is made from the husks of coconuts. Botanicoya are the company of choice. Their eco-friendly operation is based in Sri Lanka and India. Using coir substrate allows for fast root development, which in turn gives a healthier plant and an increased yield. The coir is ground, cleaned, and then dried. Once dried, it's also compressed and cut to shape. And then it's finally ready to be put into the specially designed grow bags before being exported. With the coir substrate ready, next the plants are needed. But that in itself is not as straightforward as you might think. Here's Sandy once again to tell us more.
We have, for the past 10 years, been getting different propagators from all over the world to send us their new varieties, their new selections, which can take 7 years to get from a number to a name, if it gets that far. So we're always looking at around 50 different new varieties of Junebearer, Everbearer every season. And out of that, you'd be lucky if we take 10% onto the next season. And even in the next season, we might see something completely different again and then decide, no, it's not something to push forward with. So we've got 3 very new varieties at the moment, which are so new that nobody else really has them at the moment, which is Anya, Zanti, and Cantus. We have over 500,000 of these plants at the moment. It's a gut feeling that I have when something is right, and then you have to push the button. So for next year's plants, I have to decide in April, May, June that what I want for 2021, before I've even seen the results of 2020. But I feel that if you want to be at the forefront of something, take a gamble here and there.
With the Anya, Zanti and Cantus gamble having paid off, backed up with 30 years of experience, the 3 varieties are packed by the propagator in the Netherlands and sent to the New Forest Fruit Company for replanting in the glasshouse, as well as Penally, Newhouse and Lodge Farms polytunnels. And with over 500,000 plants to decamp from box to substrate, the key workers waste no time in going up and down the rows, replanting the various varieties, ensuring the plants are correctly sown to be certain that they will take hold in their new surroundings. Each grow bag has its water supply line fitted and checked before a row can then be signed off as ready to grow. Once the strawberries are ready for picking, the New Forest Fruit Company's key workers take to the rows of soft fruit to pick those ripe enough to go into the punnet. And that's a process that has evolved over the years, as Vince Weller explains.
We looked at harvesting last year and said, how can we achieve a 2 to 3 kilo an hour increase based on last year's average to try and keep us competitive? Let's do some investigation and see what improvements we can find. And a relatively low cost tractor and trailer system allowed us to have a team of 4 people, 1 tractor driver and 3 guys behind, that would sweep up through a tunnel and collect all pick trays, and then sweep back down another tunnel and pick up all of those trays. Carefully remove that pallet from the trailer and continue the same process. A 7% improvement in picking speed by having the pickers picking more already pays for those guys. And about 90% of the fruit that's being picked is now being collected by tractors and trailers, and only at break times or at the end of a shift they will bring out the last few trays that they have.
And so, with enough fruit to fill a panel van, the next step is to take the freshly picked strawberries to the pack house for the final phase of production. Once there, the fruit is offloaded and put into the blast chillers, as pack house manager Evelina Minoich explains.
When we got the fruit, we need to chill them, so we put them in blast chillers. Then we allocate our fruit in the fridge. When we start packing, we always tell to our boys, front runners, what they need to bring for which line, because sometimes we are packing the same order on both lines, but happened that on one line we are packing one order for Sainsbury, for example, and another line will be Lidl. And we can use different type of pallets or different varieties for those two orders. So we always need to tell them which fruit to bring and from which fridge. For example, for Sainsbury will be Murano, and for Lidl, let's say, Molin Centenario. So they need to be very careful to not mix those varieties, to be sure that then we will bring them to the pack house. Then our front runners will put them on the lines for girls and boys to pack them. And then fruits are going through the heat sealer. And on the end of the line, we have runners who will collect pallets already sealed and put in the tray or box, depends for which customer. And then when pallet is ready, we will put them in dispatch fridge.
With the strawberries now in the dispatch fridge ready to be collected, the New Forest Fruit Company's many clients waste no time in arriving at Penelly Farm to take delivery, whether that be a local business or a national supermarket chain. From picking to packing, New Forest Fruit Company's soft fruits are ready to be collected within just a few short hours, ensuring the freshest, tastiest, top quality strawberries available in the UK, allowing us, the consumer, to enjoy our favourite fruit as if we just picked it ourselves.